A strict program and proper care, that's the kind of service the Treatment and Rehabilitation Center in Quezon City is offering its patients. This is the only drug treatment and rehabilitation facility in the National Capital Region. All of the buildings are still in good condition, with a 150-bed capacity. But all of the slots are already taken, and it can no longer accommodate more patients. In Quezon City alone, there are almost 4,000 drug dependents who surrendered. The local government admits they are having problems when it comes to rehabilitation facilities.
Kami ay makikipagpulong itong linggo sa lahat ng mga private rehab centers ng Quezon City at hihingi ng tulong sa kanila kung maaari silang mag-accommodate ng 5 to 10 siguro na mga surrenderees.
The PNP says as of Monday, there are 41,000 drug users who surrendered across the country. There are 20 drug treatment and rehab facilities in the country that's being operated by local government units and the health department. But these can only accommodate 5,000 patients. The DOH admits more facilities are needed. The DOH will now release an algorithm that will be the basis to where at what treatment they will give to drug dependents. This will determine if a surrenderee will be jailed for criminal liabilities or be placed in an institution or rehab centers or will undergo community-based treatment. Another suggestion is to put up rehab facilities in certain islands owned by the national government.
For security reasons and also yung parang matututukan sila. Madali yung gawin ng military or AFP engineering brigade kung kailangan. Mga makeshift, mga tents, mga cot beds.
The health department's rehab program will be funded by PAGCOR. Cory Quintos, ABS-CBN News.